It's the holiday season, and this year I was lucky enough to travel above the Arctic Circle, where I saw some reindeer. Now, while some magical reindeer may pull Santa's sleigh, your average everyday reindeer is pretty fascinating too. So today, let's talk about the bizarre side of reindeer you may never have known existed. I'm Anna, and this is Gross Science. One of the first things I noticed when I saw a reindeer this year was that their antlers were bloody. To understand why, you need to know what antlers are. Antlers are bony projections from the skulls of most male deer. But reindeer are the only species of deer in which the females grow antlers too. Antlers start out soft and are covered in a layer of skin and hair we call velvet. Blood flowing through the velvet transports lots of oxygen and nutrients to help the antlers grow quickly. However, eventually, the antlers harden and the reindeer will scrape the velvet off, making them look kind of like hangers covered in beef jerky. A few months later, the reindeer will shed their antlers and grow them anew the next year. In fact, depending on where Santa gets his reindeer, he may have an all-female sleigh team, or a team made up of castrated males called steers.
Huh?
Intact male reindeer in many parts of the world will lose their antlers before Christmas, while females and steers will keep theirs longer into winter. Now, as you know, reindeer live in places with lots of snow, so they have many adaptations to help them survive in this hostile climate. One adaptation is the ability to see UV light, which is outside the spectrum of what humans can see. Snow and ice reflect UV, so to a reindeer, anything that absorbs it will appear black and stand out in the snowy landscape. And it turns out that lichens, which the reindeer eat, and fur and urine, which can be signs of predators, all absorb UV light. We still don't know how reindeer protect their eyes from UV damage, though. When humans encounter that much UV light, we can experience something called snow blindness, which is basically a sunburn on your eyeballs.
Ugh.
Anyway, reindeer may be very well adapted to their cold environment, but the climate of the Arctic is changing. And a multi-year study in Svalbard has found that global warming may have dire impacts on reindeer populations. As the climate warms, there's more food available in the summer, which makes females healthier and able to get pregnant more easily. But warmer temperatures in the winter means that rain falls more frequently on top of the snow. And when it freezes, it forms an icy layer that the reindeer can't dig through to get to the plants and lichens that they need to survive the winter months. And that means that there isn't enough food to go around for all the reindeer mothers to be. So mothers have been giving birth to smaller calves and even terminating their pregnancies if they're not getting enough food. Climate change would not only be a problem for these animals, but also for the people who rely on them. Various northern indigenous groups have domesticated these animals and used them for transportation, milk, meat, and fur. And they're still important for many people's livelihood today. So we shouldn't just think about reindeer over the holidays. We should do what we can to protect them all year round. Ew. Hey everyone, one additional fact. Caribou are technically the same species as reindeer, but in North America, we call wild animals caribou and domesticated animals reindeer. The two can mate, but they do behave differently and have some physiological differences as well. In Europe, however, wild animals in places like Svalbard are called reindeer and not caribou. Anyway, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you have a question about reindeer, leave it in the comments. And for more gross science, hit subscribe.